Acharya Anil Sahasrabuddheji, Chairman AICTE, Sri Reddy Subramanyamji, Sachiv Bharat Sarkar, Acharya PK Deshaiji, Dr. Udesh Kohliji, और इस समारोह में भाग ले रहे अन्य अतिथिगण फैकल्टी मेंबर्स देश भर से आए हुए छात्र मित्रों बहनों और भाइयों मुझे उन उत्साही युवा छात्रों को AICTE-EI-ISTE छात्र विश्वकर्मा पुरस्कार और AICTE-SAGY पहल पुरस्कार प्रदान करते हुए हर्ष की अनुभूति हो रहा है. आई रियली फील वेरी हैप्पी दैट आई कुड कम हियर टुडे टू दिस इनोवेटिव फंक्शन ऑफ द AICTE प्रोग्राम एंड देन कुड ब्लेस सम ऑफ द ब्राइट माइंड्स ऑफ इंडिया आवर चिल्ड्रन जिन्होंने प्रौद्योगिकी की माध्यम से गांवों के सशक्तिकरण के मूल लक्ष्य के अनुरूप अपने विलक्षण विचारों का बखूबी प्रदर्शन किया है और मैं उन लोगों को आशीर्वाद देना चाहता हूं. आई एम रियली वेरी हैप्पी एंड आई विजिटेड सम ऑफ द स्टॉल्स एंड आई इंटरेक्टेड विद द चिल्ड्रन फॉर सम टाइम. आई कुड सी द कॉन्फिडेंस द एंथुजियाज्म अमंग दीज यंगस्टर्स and I am assured of the future of this country that it will be safe and secure in our hands. God bless you all. I am delighted to present these awards, initiatives which have been taken to those passionate young students who have showcased their ideas in tune with the theme of empowerment of villages through technologies. This is another interesting subject an aspect of public life for me because I come from a village with an agriculture background and I see that the villages are lagging behind vis-a-vis cities because cities are more organized, they are more attended to by all the systems and they are more vocal also, and the rural areas they suffer on account of lack of so many other amenities. Successive governments of course have made efforts. Sriman Atal Bihari Vajpayee, late Prime Minister of Atal Bihari Vajpayee, he brought connectivity revolution in the country, air connectivity, rail connectivity, highway connectivity, rural connectivity, teleconnectivity, television connectivity, port connectivity, because connectivity is the key for development. At that time, it was my fortune, I was Minister for Rural Development and then Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee has agreed to our suggestion to have Pradhanamantri Gramin Sadak Yojana, because that road connectivity to the village is a key for development. Why I am saying is, the country is moving forward, the world is moving faster, and the village should not be allowed to lag behind. And the only way is, of course, policy formulations, more attention towards rural development, but at the same time, the technology, the new innovations should reach the rural people, the unorganized people, particularly farming community. That is the need of the hour. That's why I would like to appreciate the AICTE for taking this initiative to motivate our young children to come out with new innovations to help the farming community, to help empower them through technology. I'm also delighted to know that faculty mentors have worked hard to counsel these students to convert their brilliant and innovative ideas into feasible, functional prototypes. I'm happy to note that AICTE in association with ECI and ISTE has conceived the Chhatra Vishwakarma Awards for challenging our young students to come up with novel ideas that have great potential to impact the life in our villages through technological interventions at the grassroots level. In the Rig Veda, the most ancient of all Vedas, Lord Vishwakarma is revered as the deity who is the original creator, architect and divine engineer of the universe. My dear youngsters, I would like to tell you that this land India, Bharat. This water, this air, and this people have something special in them. There is knowledge in everybody, not only students, not only professors, not only researchers, not only doctorates. You take the common man, the farmer, the taddy tapper, the goldsmith, the blacksmith, anybody for that matter, he has some talent or other. What is required is little upgradation, identifying the talent, upgrading it, encouraging it. That's why I'm happy that the Prime Minister Narendra Bhai Modi has started a skill development ministry, separate ministry, to identify the skills and promote the skills. This land was known as Vishwaguru once upon a time, Bharat. Students from abroad, they used to come and study here in Nalanda, in Takshashila, in Pushpagiri. This is not what we are saying. The famous historians, Pahian, Huan Song, Chinese historians, they came and they wrote about India and its greatness. At that time itself, Susruta in Shastra Shastra, Charaka, these great doctors at the time, and even Aryabhatta, Bhaskaracharya, Varaha Mihira, so many names were there. They were all the creators, knowledge givers to the society. So you have inherited such a culture, work, knowledge from those great people, and we must further develop on that and then see to it that our technology and research, what is the meaning of research and technology? Purpose is to upgrade the lives of the people, make them more happy and comfortable. That is the purpose of science. Innovation is to improve the living condition of the people. I hope that this event, named after the creative genius Vishwakarma, will inspire each and every one of you to conceive ingenious new ideas and technologies and create inventive and innovative solutions to pressing problems at hand. Mere pyare yuva doston, hamare rashtrapita Mahatma Gandhi ne kaha tha, Bharat ka bhavishya iske gaon mein nihit hai. The future of India lies in its villages. Main is vichar se puri tarah sahmat hu. Gandhi ji has given two advices. One advice is political. I don't want to dwell on that. He said, after attaining freedom, disband the Congress. That was his suggestion. The idea was disbanded by people. That's a different matter. I don't want to get into that. Second suggestion was, he said, back to villages. Go back to villages. But unfortunately, leaders have shown their back to villages and moved towards towns. With the result, today there is an urban-rural divide. So we must now again, after this understanding of experience, see to it that we focus more on village, more on agriculture, more on rural-related development, so that there is an equitable development, so that there is an inclusive growth. That is the need of the hour. Farming is becoming a challenging task. People are leaving agriculture. It's a cause of concern. A country of 130 crore population. If agriculture is neglected, then there will be a food problem. Fortunately, thanks to the scientists, thanks to the farmers, we have surplus food as of now. We have food security. But our galloping population, you cannot depend on imported food security. You have to develop homegrown food security. We are not Dubai. We are not Singapore. Small countries to just import everything and have fresh vegetables, fresh food and all. So you need to have homegrown food security. So that being the case, we must come to the assistance of the agriculturists and farmers with new technologies, new ideas to take care of the challenges they are facing in their respective fields. Yesterday, I have been to the birthplace of Sardar Vallabhai Patel, the unifier of India. I saw his village. I saw the memorial built there in the village. And also, I was fortunate to visit the Statue of Unity, the tallest statue in the world, created by the present government Prime Minister's initiative, and wherein I could read, I could understand further the life of Sardar Vallabhai Patel. His understanding of India, understanding of India, and particularly the rural life and the farmers, because he led the Kheda Satyagraha earlier, then Badori Satyagraha under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi. All this was for the cause of the rural people. So such a visionary leader really has inspired the country. And we, as the younger generation, for the unity and integrity of the country, for the safety and security of the people, we must come out with new innovations to help the agriculturist, help the rural people, help the other vocations to come up with new ideas, new solutions to the challenges they are facing, and make agriculture viable, sustainable, make the other activities also are viable and sustainable and profitable, so that people get engaged into those activities. मैंने हमेशा यह माना है कि छात्रों को ग्रामीण क्षेत्रों में समय बिताने के लिए प्रोत्साहित किया जाना चाहिए, गांवों के संपर्क में वे वहां का लोगों का समस्याओं का समझ सकेंगे। मैं अपने सार्वजनिक जीवन में व्यक्तिगत रूप से गांव और ग्रामीणों का कल्याण से जुड़ा रहा हूं, गांवों का विकास मेरे हृदय के बहुत करीब रहा है। यह ध्यान देने वाली बात है कि AICTE, जो भारत में टेक्नोलॉजी का शिक्षा के लिए नियामक संस्था है, राष्ट्र के विकास में सहायक बनने के लिए उन्होंने एक प्रयास अच्छा प्रयास कर रहा है। I have always maintained that the students should be encouraged to spend time in rural areas, interacting with people and understanding the problems that they face. Interventions from education institutions, which are often fountainheads of innovation, can dramatically transform the rural landscape and find solutions to the most crucial issues. I applaud the efforts of those institutes which have been awarded the AICTE-SAGY Initiative Award. I congratulate AICTE for having taken this momentous step at a time when we are working tirelessly to improve the plight of our villages. It is heartening to note that AICTE, which is the regulator for technical education in India, is spreading its wings to become a facilitator for the development of the nation. My dear students, I believe that India has the potential to not only become the world's fastest growing economy, but also to serve as an inspiration, a model to the rest of the world. But in order to achieve this coveted goal, India must steer itself towards eco-friendly industrialization, sustainable urbanization, and inclusion of the rural economy. According to the census 2011, nearly 69% of our population lives in rural areas and depends on agriculture-related activities. The socio-economic census data 2011 says that almost 73% of the households are in rural areas, 2011, of course. Now there might have been further urbanization. Yet, unfortunately, our vision for development is still largely urban-centric. Our media, our parliament, our political parties, everybody focus more on urban because, as I told you, they are all organized. I have the advantage of working both as rural development minister, even as urban development minister also, in two successive governments of Vajpayee and Advani, and Narendra Bhai Modi now. Under Vajpayee, Advani leadership at that time, as Prime Minister and Deputy Prime Minister, and then Narendra Modi as the Prime Minister. I have seen both these things. See, these urban areas, people are coming for education, employment, entertainment, economic upliftment, enhanced medical facilities, and urban areas are getting congested. You have to understand, so you have to stop this to some extent, because if you make agriculture sustainable, if you make village life comfortable, if you provide them with connectivity, road, transport, drinking water, irrigation facilities, crop insurance, and if you make agriculture more viable, you have to come with new innovations, diversification of crops, value addition, food processing. And then pest menace is a big challenge. I have seen just now some of the children has come with new innovations. And assured power supply also is equally important. People now talk about, because politicians competitive populism is going on, they talk about free power. I am of the opinion free power can only be temporary. Free power means first no low power. Free power means first low power, then no power. No power is free power only. What is required is assured power. 24/7 power, that is what is required. We must plan in that direction. So these loan waivers also are temporary solution. What is required is making agriculture sustainable. These are some of the areas, of course, they are policy matters to be left to the government. But innovations will help them to come out with new ideas is the responsibility of the institutions across the country. That's why I'm particularly happy when Sahasra Buddhaji came to me and told me about this innovative program. I thought this is the need of the hour. Every institute must encourage children to focus more on villages, more on agriculture. The rural India still lags behind on urban India in terms of crucial development indicators. Rural economy is still characterized by lack of sufficient amenities such as clean water, health, education, and a dearth of employment opportunities. Insufficient banking, communication technology, market, and warehousing facilities continue to plague rural agriculture industry. Rural society still faces challenges of poverty, gender inequality, and also rampant discrimination. Though we have made considerable progress in the sphere of rural development, much more needs to be done to make rural India economically, socially, and politically empowered. Since agriculture is still the mainstay of rural economy, agriculture is our basic culture of India. We have to constantly innovate and reinvent our agriculture practices in tune with the realities of diminishing natural resources and changing weather and rainfall patterns. Students of agriculture, engineering, and allied sciences must spend more time in agriculture fields to devise solutions to improve productivity and sustainability of our agriculture. It's not doing research in the lab alone. You must visit the fields. And in fact, I am suggesting that all people who are doing these courses, they must spend considerable time in the village, make night halts, spend time with the families, see the agriculture, sericulture, fishiculture, aquaculture, every culture of the people, yourself, and then understand the real challenges rather than getting bookish knowledge and then come out with solutions. AICTE also should rephrase its courses in such a way, some time is spent in rural area, some time is spent on agriculture. Engineering also has a relevance to agriculture and other allied activities. I was there in Gujarat yesterday, as I was telling you, Karamsad, the birthplace of Sardar Patel. Next door is Amul Dairy. What a wonderful transformation it has brought in there. So keeping that in mind, I hope that the AICTE in future, and the HRD minister, I have been discussing with him also, to come out, and you go for change of syllabus, you must reorient and have courses which will make it mandatory for the children to spend some time in the rural area and in the agriculture sector and allied sectors. Our government is doing its best. I don't deny that. The Prime Minister is taking a lot of initiatives, particularly for the agriculture, particularly for the rural development and all. He has now thought to it that every village is electrified. Next target should be every village house has to be electrified. Now every village also is connected with the roads, thanks to Pradhan Mantri Sadak Yojana. Now present Prime Minister is pushing on that also. He brought in crop insurance also. And also he is coming with other ideas. But at the same time, as I told you, unless the younger generation comes with new innovative ideas, agriculture sustainability will become a major problem. I hope these initiatives which you have taken will serve as launch pads for the young budding inventors and scientists such as yourself. My dear young friends, India is a vast and diverse country. One size fits all programs and policies will not ensure development in India. Every state, every village has its own individuality, its own traditional crafts and industries, and its own very special set of developmental needs. The people in villages have a certain unique set of skills and capabilities. When we plan development, these factors must be taken into consideration. In essence, the plan should capture the aspirations of the people, leverage their strengths, and mitigate their weaknesses. Development is not necessarily building skyscrapers. It could very well be empowering the local craftsmen and entrepreneurs and enabling small and medium industries. it has been found that small medium enterprises, MSMEs, account for 45% of the industrial value addition and 40% of the workforce. Thus, development of rural areas should not erode their unique identities, but most fortify their spirits. These amenities in villages must resemble those of a city, but the soul and the value of Indian villages must be preserved. That's why I always say, you must, part of your life, love and live with the nature. Love and live with the nature. Nature, culture, together for better future. Should never ignore nature. We have our own advantages. My dear students, there is a lot of indiscretion and arbitrariness in the way we consume natural resources today. It has been found that at the current population, the rate of resource consumption, we need 1.5 years to survive. It's a very serious issue. Therefore, I urge each and every one of you to consider the environmental cost of your inventions and innovations on a priority basis when you measure their feasibility. We can no longer afford to neglect our ecological footprint. I do not believe that development and environmental conservation are mutually exclusive goals. They can be complementary. With a focus on green and clean resources of energy, reduction in consumption and efficient waste management, we can very well make our villages hubs of progress as well as sanctuaries for thriving ecosystems. The Prime Minister's foresight of giving Swachh Bharat program to the country. Swachh Bharat, Beti Bachao, Beti Padao, Par Ra, Par Krap. So many programs, these programs should become people's programs. Yoga, because of lifestyle changes, you need some amount of exercise. Because of sedentary lifestyle, new diseases are coming. We have to keep all these things in mind and make these movements as people's movements. It's for the youngsters of the country. Swachh Bharat is for, Swachh Bharat and yoga, they are for your body, not for Modi. Some people think, it's a Modi ji ka karyakram hai. Modi ji is healthy, there's no problem. But a healthy nation can become a wealthy nation. But there's no guarantee a wealthy nation can become a healthy nation. We have so much wealth and you have diabetic. You can't eat even sweet. Or even food, good food also. So healthy. We have to focus on all this and make it part of our life. My dear youngsters, this lifestyle changes also is a matter of concern. We must all go back to our roots and see to it that our lifestyle has certain amount of physical activity and touch with the nature, touch with the water, touch with the air, touch with the sun. You have deficiency. Go and check yourself. Many of you will have these. D3 deficiencies, B12 deficiencies and all, because we are ignoring nature and our lifestyle is becoming mechanical. You get up, get down from the bed, then get on to the dining table, get down from the dining table, get on to cycle, motorcycle, car or bus, go to the office, get on to your table and then get down from the table, then again dining table, then get down and then again get on to the vehicle. Go to the office and get on to your seat and then get down and then finally after dinner get on to the bed and get down. There is no physical activity at all. There is no physical, everything is mechanical now. See, physical activity is also equally important. Earlier I remember during my student days we used to go to bathroom, bend, take water, put on your head. Now you have a shower. Water is coming on you, no need to even bend. And we used to sit on charpai, mat, and then eat. Now you have a dining table, no bending. Earlier we used to eat with hands. Now some people are habituated to eat with spoons. And then earlier you have to go out and wash your hand. Now you have a finger bowl. Earlier to make a phone call, you have to go a little away. Now phone has come to your house. Earlier it used to be in a corner. You have to go there and pick up the phone. Now the phone has come to your ear and mouth. Literally physical activity is missing. This is a very important aspect one has to. Certain amount of physical activity is required. Then food habits also. Food habits. You may be surprised why the Vice President of India is telling us about food habits and all. It is for the survival of the nation, the younger generation. We should not be carried away by the fast food. Now people say instant food. Instant food means constant disease. This has to be understood. Lot of research is coming nowadays. You might have seen today also newspapers also. There are a lot of articles about the food which we are consuming. See, Indian food is time tested according to seasons, suitability. Thousands of years of civilization, our forefathers have recommended this. They are good, but somehow because of fascination, westernization, this TV advertisement business, branding and all, we look to the other food. Pizza, burger, stored food, junked food everywhere. People are now trying to discard it. And Indian people, youngsters, still that. I am not against any foreign food, but we are Indians. Na? First, let us try our food. Na? Our idli, our sambar, our dosa, our pongal, our vada, our chicken, our curries, they are time tested. Na? Pav bhaji, our dokla, so many things. In India, every item is very tasty, but we have weakness of brand, Kentucky Fried Chicken, McDonald's. Stored food is no good at all. When you have fresh food, why should you go for stored food? Second is about the food also, the names, branding names. You go to hotel, restaurant, and then go through the cart. Chicken 65. Your age is 25, and you order 65. And you order this, chicken manchuria. What is this manchuria, Bulgaria, Somalia? we have our own chicken items. You go to Hyderabad biryani, Moti Mahal biryani in Delhi. Excellent, but fascination because of the temptation, because of colonial rule and mindset, somehow that will be tempting. What I am suggesting is, what is good available to us according to seasons, we must consume that food so that we can be healthy. This small point, you may think that I have deviated. No, this is going to be a major challenge in the coming days. In the coming days, food habits are going to be a major challenge for the survival of the humanity, for your health, and also lifestyle. These two aspects cannot be ignored at all. Depression is coming now. People are committing suicide. Why all these things are happening? One has to understand all this. So, my dear friends, so we must focus on green and clean source of energy, reduction in consumption. There was an article yesterday, 10% of the people are suffering with excessive food, obesity. And 10% of the people are suffering without food. See the dichotomy, worldwide this is the. So we have to, how much is required? How much we have to eat? Protein food. In spite of having food security, there is a hidden hunger in India. You know what is that? Protein deficiency, nutritional deficiency. These are the areas we must make study and then try to educate the people. And the youngsters, if they can take up such campaign, it will catch up very easily. Let me remind you that our country is on a relentless quest for maximize our renewable energy potential and has recently increased its previous target of 2022 capacity target for renewable energy from 175 GW gigawatts to 227.6 gigawatts. We have such a beautiful sun in India. Sometime back I was in London. The driver who was driving my car, he said, "Sir, good morning." I said, "Okay, namaste." Then he said, "Sir, today is a sunny day." I said, "Is it your son's birthday?" "No, sir, sunny day. Sun is bright." I told him, "Poor fellow, in India 365 days are sunny days." But we never harnessed the sun. We ignored it all these days, both for health reasons and also for power. Now, the Prime Minister has taken a lead to go for solar alliance along with France. 120 countries have joined together. Everybody is realizing the power tariff. Thermal power, 6 rupees 70 paise.
Now solar power, it has come down to 2 rupees 60 paise or 70 paise. See the change. This is the innovation. These are the areas, critical areas on which you have to focus. That makes the life of the people more comfortable, accessible, affordable, of all these facilities. You have to come up with such new ideas. The brunt of global warming and changing weather patterns, including unseasonal rains, flood and drought, are borne mostly by the poor and the marginalized, especially the farmers. I therefore urge you to give clean energy place of paramount importance in your technological innovations. I'm happy some of the children have shown it to me. Ours is a vast country with complex challenges but infinite opportunities. Urban India is witnessing industrial revolution. However, I must impress upon you that the hinterlands of the country, one can find industry which is not up to the mark. So this has to coexist, rural and urban industries. You as technocrats must be flexible enough to adapt your innovations to suit the needs of all those various phases of industrial revolution. My dear young friends, I must not fail to impress upon you that in our bid to develop rural India, we must not falter in our attempts to facilitate the development of urban India. There has to be balance. With 34% of the population living in cities, urban India is already the world's second largest country. Hundreds of millions more migrate to India cities. Yet only 10 cities have metro rail and 15 more have metro construction in the pipeline. We need to go for public transport. We must move away from the private transport to public transport. Private transport is causing havoc. See the Delhi traffic, Bangalore traffic, traffic of the many cities, Calcutta traffic, because everybody separate car. Emissions are there, pollution is there, cost also, but public transport is more comfortable. We have to import metro engines from Korea, from other countries and all. We have to come out with new ideas, new inventions, new research on this. Much more investment is needed for improving mobility, connectivity and ease of living in urban areas. I'm happy now the government of India is laying optical fiber to 250,000 villages. It's going to really revolutionize the system across the country. We have the largest number of cell phones in our country. And we, with all this, should we import the cell phones from outside? Can't we make those chips here? We have to understand. Small things, we have to focus on that. These potato chips, potatoes, there's no demand. Potato chips, same potato chips, 10 rupee kilo potato and 400 rupees chips packet because of brand. Can't we cut the potato, boil it, cut it and then make a chips and give a name, brand name? Should we not make it into a movement in India? Small things. See these, one example I have given you. Tomato in our area, Madanapalli, in the peak season, tomato is not even 1 rupee. And same time, you go to Bengaluru, 120 kilometers away, 6 rupees. You come to Delhi, it will be 20 rupees. Onion, Nasik, production, peak season, prices go down. And then you come to Delhi, you know, once Delhi, one party lost election because of onion prices. Onion, storage, cold storage, refrigeratory vans, new ideas of storage. These are the areas we have to focus to make life of the people comfortable. And then we must also change the mindset of the people that we have enough knowledge, we have enough capabilities, and we can withstand. At the same time, please understand, that's the last point I want to stress upon you, that we are living in a LPG. Liberalization, privatization, globalization. If you take advantage of LPG and do it properly, you can utilize it properly, you can run motors and also have good cooking gas, etc. If you mishandle LPG, what will happen, I need not explain to you. Keeping that in mind, we must come out with solutions. World is small now. What is happening in India is known in America in few minutes. What is happening there is known. People's aspirations also are high. India, fortunately, we have a demographic dividend. 65% of the Indian population is below 35 years. We have an aspirational India. So keeping these challenges in mind, we must go for new innovations. The Prime Minister has given a 3-line advice. He said mantra or advice, whatever you call. He said reform, perform, transform. Transform the nation, transformation. Transformation for better living conditions of the people. That is the requirement. You should all be part, we are all stakeholders in the same system. We should all be partners in this transformation process that is going on. A lot of transformation is coming, I do agree. 36 crore people have opened a bank account. Some people initially said bank account open karne mein matlab kya hai? Paisa nahi hai to khata kholne mein matlab hai kya sir? Aisa kuch logon ne mere se bhi pucha, us samay main mantri tha. Magar aisa logon ko 2016 November 8 tarikh sham ko bank ka khata kitna mahatvapurna hai samajh mein aaya. When the Prime Minister came on radio and television and started saying bhaiyo aur behno, then they realized the importance and then started asking drivers and cooks attendants, bhai aapke paas hai to bank account hai na, kuch din ke liye paisa main usme rakh sakta hu kya. It's an empowerment of the people. It's an empowerment of the people. All this DBT, direct benefit transfer, directly trans scholarship, pension, compensation, insurance, coming to your bank account. Online, so that there is no line. That should be our main line in our life. Online, you apply and get reply. Otherwise, deemed to have been replied. Ease of approvals, ease of doing business, new ideas. One must come with those such ideas and such innovations. At the JAM, Janathana, Aadhaar and mobile. Finally, whatever entitlement is there, it should come to you. You need not go and stand in office and go around the office number of times. Go, greet, meet, shake hand, do something in between hand. That should not be there. At the end of it, that is digitization. That is the technology where you should use it for the betterment of the lives of the people so that you can arrest corruption, you can arrest pilferage, you can arrest leakage. These ideas will definitely help you. The GST, the great revolutionary taxation transformation, you will see the effect of it after some time. Initially, any transformation, any reform, there will be some pain. But I tell you, my dear youngsters, temporary pain for long-term gain. I remember during my child days when the health people came to put tika. You know, tika. Many of you might have gone through tika. So we, some of us boys, we ran away. Boy, tika means painful hoga. So I ran away and then climbed a cattle shed and hiding there. Those fellows, seems to be sincere fellows, they came and then they also climbed the cattle shed and then put the tika here in the back. Because I was avoiding my this thing. I had that mark is there even now for me. Temporary pain for long-term gain. You take all these medicines, not nowadays. Hepatitis B, why all this? There will be some little amount of discomfort, but it will be useful. You have to take certain hard steps. Sometime again there was discussion, I don't want to go in detail to that, about this demonetization. When people said, "By fake currency is there, a lot of other things are there, black money is coming, change has to be there and all." So one gentleman, at the time I was in government, I am not in politics now. I am retired from politics, but not from public life. That's why I am talking to you on these issues. So they said, "Sir, what is this, sir? This is a transformation. No, no, very painful, sir. You have to go and stand in." I said, "Definitely." And then I gave him an example at the time. If you suppose you are affected with cancer, what do? You have to go for medication. Then you have to, at the end of it, you have to go for chemotherapy. Then he said, "Sir, chemotherapy, that means there will be hair fall." I said, "You have a choice." He said, "Sir, what is the choice? You can choose whether you want to have hair fall or your fall. You decide whatever you want." My suggestion is, that is a political issue, let them debate. In democracy, people have got right to oppose it and offer better alternative systems also. What I am saying is, you have to come out with certain new innovations, invasions, which will help speedy reach to the people, accessible to the people, stop corruption, stop exploitation, stop middlemen, stop delay, more comfort. As I told you about solar, 6 rupees 60 paise to 2 rupees 60 paise, profit, benefit. This is the purpose of innovation. Innovation is for the betterment of the human lives. So keeping that in mind, the youngsters of India, particularly the fortunate children who are able to get into engineering colleges and other things, we must take advantage of this 3Ds, demography, demand, and there is a lot of demand in our country, and democracy. What is making India today outshine other countries in the world is the 3Ds. The entire focus is now on India. The World Bank, the World Economic Forum report, the ADB, Asian Development Bank, are the Moody's ratings, not Modi's ratings, Moody's ratings. Everybody is saying India has got a bright future. The latest report says, in coming few years, India will become the third largest economy. Largest economy. We all are saying. And there is wide appreciation. I was there in Gujarat, vibrant Gujarat yesterday. 135 country reference have come. They want to invest in India because India is a place of happening. But at the same time, here in India, we must see to it that we bridge the urban-rural gap. We must make agriculture more profitable. And we must see that the growth, India becomes the largest economy, fine. But people are still suffering with poverty. Then, can you call it as a growth? So you must see to it that this aspects are taken into care through technology, through new innovations, and reach out such sections which are suffering and take care of them on priority by the use of technology and see to it that they also become partners in the development of the country. It is heartening to know that more than 1600 teams from across India participated in this event with contribution of nearly 1700 girl students across all teams. There is a need to empower girls, encourage girls. I'm happy when I go around the country as a vice president, address our convocations. I could see that the gold medalists, more than 65% are girls. If you give an encouragement to the girls, they will outshine. So we have to encourage the girls. And we have to see to it that they are given a little amount of support so that they also can become equal partners. The AICTE-SAGY Initiative Award, will definitely inspire all the higher education institutions in the country who wish to participate in Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. I would like to reiterate that collective vigor and energy of our younger minds is the force that is catalyzing the resurgence of India. The Prime Minister is talking of New India, where there is no hunger, where there is no exploitation, where there is no discrimination, where there is no divide. So that is possible only with the help of the younger minds. Excellence should be our goal, our mantra. We owe it to the billion dreams that propel our country forward to be a global leader in all respect. Mujhe ummid hai ki aap seekhna, nava pravartan karna aur prerit karna jari rakhenge. Mujhe aapki drushti aur aapki kshamataon par bahut vishwas hai. I have abundant confidence that you people will continue your pursuing of knowledge and then innovative thinking and then make a mark in your life and then make a mark in the life of the country. I wish you all great success in your endeavors to make India the world's capital of knowledge, wisdom and wealth. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.